Well, it is Wednesday. Chef George is here. Yes, it's snowing outside, and Portland Public House is making wild dogs today.
Why does Mother Nature hate
us? I don't know what it is. Every Wednesday, you're here. It's snowing out.
Horrible. It's horrible.
What are we making today?
Wild boar sausage. It's the official...
I've never had that before.
The baseball season opened.
Well, I know that, yeah.
It was open in Australia, but it opened.
I've never had wild boar before.
Well, you've had pork sausage before, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's the cousin to domestic pig.
Okay.
It's very lean, very tender, very tasty, a little sweeter, has less of that... hate to say the word pork taste, but like that. So it's very meaty.
Good.
You know, it's delicious.
All right, so let's go over the ingredients that we have.
It's really simple. We're going to make some sweetened sauerkraut.
Nice.
All right, so we shred up some carrots.
Okay.
I've got some thyme and some garlic. I'm making beer mustard to go with it. So Dijon and yellow mustard mixed together with some dark beer.
I've never had that either.
And
I have lived a sheltered life, apparently.
You're a finicky eater.
I am a finicky eater.
And then obviously fries to go with it.
Okay.
And the wild boar.
Easy enough to make. And you and I were talking, you said this was probably one of the easiest recipes that you've ever brought to us here.
By far the easiest recipe that I've ever made here.
You've ever made. Where are we getting that wild...
Well, that comes from a specialty farmer. You can get it at, I think, Wild Harvest sells it.
Okay.
Ours comes from a specialty farmer from one of our suppliers.
But it's easy enough to get.
It's easy enough to get.
Okay, sounds good to us. Snowing outside, we're going to have some dogs and pretend that it's sunny and 80 degrees outside and baseball season is here. All right, let's get to it. Back to you.
Now back to Michaela with Chef George in the kitchen.
Hey, I told you I'd get him to do it. Is everyone ready?
Ready.
Ready?
Ready? Yeah.
Alay, Poppy. Nice. I knew Chef George would always be up for anything. You always get something great going on in the kitchen today, and this gets me in the mood for warm weather and baseball season.
Absolutely, absolutely. So while you guys were doing your thing, I got the shredded cabbage. Not carrots. I said carrots earlier, but I mean cabbage.
Okay.
Sorry. I got that in the water with the vinegar, the sugar, the garlic, and the thyme.
Okay.
You're going to let that simmer for about a half an hour.
Mm-hmm.
I took the sausages, and I steamed them in a little bit of water.
Great.
And then what we're going to do is once all of the fat drains out of it and you drain it out, I'm just going to pop them in the oven for a few minutes.
Okay.
Okay, and that'll just cook them.
Great.
And then while we're keeping that in the oven, we're going to make the beer mustard.
All right.
So if you want to take your yellow mustard.
Okay.
And just scrape that in.
You got it.
And then you want to take the Dijon mustard.
Nice. All right. So this is going to have a little kick.
It's
going to
have a kick. Yep. And the recipe's on the website. I broke it down into versus cups and teaspoons and stuff. I broke it down to parts depending upon how much you want to make.
Sure, yeah.
You know, so the ratios are there.
How many guests you have.
And then I like using the BBC product for this specific beer, for this specific mustard. It's the black and tan, so it's a very dark beer, and it has a sweet aftertaste.
I like that.
So you want to put about half of that in.
Okay.
All right.
What do we do with the other half?
Yeah, that's for with the hot dogs later.
Hey, okay. there we go.
And then if we can just whisk this together, and we want to put it on low heat. And get that
going.
It
doesn't need anything else,
nope,
right?
That's it. Just whisk it until it all incorporates. And then you're going to let that simmer for about 20 minutes. It'll thicken up, and we're good to go.
Great.
Simple.
And then when we come back, we are going to check in on our dogs again.
Yep.
And make them up.
Yep, exactly.
Put
the whole thing together and eat it, and it's going to be delicious.
Sounds good to me. All right, that's all coming up.
That looks perfect. That's absolutely perfect.
Thank you.
Chef George has done it again. He is here on a Wednesday. Portsmouth Public House is the place everybody's crowding in because they all want to see what this guy has made. Wild dogs is what we're making today.
Mm-hmm.
And I got to tell you, homemade French fries is also one of the things he's making.
Yep.
Sausage here.
Yep.
Mustard. All great.
Yep. It's perfect.
It's perfect.
And I'm telling you, it's the easiest thing to make. I mean, these French fries, we make peddler fries at our restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
So what we do is we take our baked potatoes and we just slice them because I don't have a fryolator. I really don't like fryolators.
Right.
So I do everything on the grill top.
Okay.
So we bake our potatoes and then we just go ahead and flip them like that. They come nice and golden brown. A little salt, a little pepper.
Oh, man.
Crispy fries.
You know?
I
just turned that down. Yeah. I'm afraid that's going to splash.
Crispy fries are my favorite. Okay,
and am I in that one?
Yeah,
well, this one here, when he flipped it over.
Okay,
and it was,
there you go. You have that one.
I was almost ready to dive in there if it was and grab that out of there. All right, let's talk about this, too, because it's a different type of sausage people
are
used to.
Yeah, it's a boar sausage.
Right.
So, and boar is the cousin to the domestic pig that we have here in the United States.
It's like Ancestry.com here.
Yeah,
here
exactly. And then, so what I did is I steamed them in a little bit of water because I like draining all that. You see the extra, I don't know if the audience can see that or not, but there's a little extra grease.
How long does that take to kind of sweat out?
4 or 5 minutes.
Oh, all right.
And then I just threw it in the oven. for at 350 for about 15, 20 minutes.
Nice.
But you can cook it any way you want to cook it. You can throw it on the grill. You can just do it in a saute pan. The beautiful thing about this is that if you've got all of the, let me shut that off. If you've got all the ingredients or and you don't even need the wild boar. You can use Italian sausage with this. Or pork. I mean,
so
you could use pork chop, like boneless pork. People might say, geez, you know, the sausage is a little too fatty for me.
Right.
Just julienne the boneless pork loin and throw some of the cabbage on top of it and throw it in the bun.
This combination sounds great to me, though. I think it would work. Or bacon.
Yeah, wild boar.
Cranberries in there. I don't
wild
know.
Wild boar. It has Shiraz wine inside of it and cranberries. And
so you have the Shiraz wine, but then you have beer, too, in this mustard that we made, which has thickened up now. It's been a couple minutes.
Yep. What's going to happen is the emulsifiers that are inside the mustard. Mustard has a natural thickening agent inside of it, the mustard seed itself. I got to put this down, Michaela. It's kind of a little warm.
Yeah, I don't want to burn your hand.
Just be careful with that plate. It's very warm.
Okay.
So the mustards have a natural emulsifier inside of it, so it's going to, when you boil it, it's going to thicken up, right?
Yeah.
And it's perfect.
Nice.
And that's the consistency it should be.
Okay.
You know, it shouldn't be like that heavy, duty yellow mustard when you got to squeeze it really hard.
Right.
It should just drizzle right on. You know?
And then you have the cabbage here.
Yep, the cabbage is all done. You want it so it's not overdone. It's just so it's nice and light and crispy, but still has the flavor of the salt and the sweet and the vinegar inside of it.
Yeah, you don't want to kill it. You don't want to overdo it
And that's all set.
Beautiful.
And it's like
so
I said.
So then you would layer those up?
Yep, it's the easiest thing. You just take your bun, put your mustard inside of it.
Right.
The sausage.
Put that on there.
Yeah, you put the kraut on top of it, a little bit more.
And you're good to go.
And we're good to go.
If you're having a party at the house, this is a perfect thing for you to make. Or even for dinner some night, just throw this together.
It's so easy. It's different.
Yeah.
Your guests are going to love it.
Oh, my God, these French fries.
You know? And and this is it. I mean, the deal is the sauerkraut and the mustard.
Right.
So that application you can use on anything. You can use it on chicken. You can use it on pork chop.
Right.
Even beef. You don't have to put it in a sandwich. You can make it as an actual entree.
Okay.
Well, easy on the fries.
I know.
You're drooling.
I know I am.
I think I need to cut it, guys.
And let's talk about the rest.
Here it is.
If you're going to cut that one, you know what? I'm going to save this one. I'm going to have the other side.
So messy. Ready?
Delicious.
It's so good.
It's perfect.
You're not supposed to talk with your mouth full. Give everybody the address.
600 Clock Tower Square, Portsmouth.
Give everyone a dog.
Wednesdays are free chicken wings.
Right.
And Fridays are free oysters.
Uh-huh.
We just launched a new express breakfast menu.
Yep.
$4 for a breakfast sandwich, 99 cents for a cup of coffee.
So awesome.
Yeah.
I love these. All right. Make sure you take this recipe. If you're going to take any recipe from Chef George, I mean, you should take them all, but definitely take this one to make it for your friends at home. You can find it on WPRI.com.